package in there?
Don't worry, she can't see us.
Dream? How do you feel? You look a little flushed.
I just didn't sleep very well. That's all.
Jan, I brought some medication.
Oh, okay.
You all right?
Yeah, I'll be out in a second.
Hi, Kate.
Sleep all right?
Yeah.
Good. I thought it better to let you sleep in.
What time is it?
9 o'clock. They're already here waiting in my study.
My God, I'm not even ready.
It's all right. Relax. Don't panic. There's plenty of time. They can wait.
She would have woken me up.
You need rest. Look. Before we go downstairs, I really think you ought to reconsider. I still don't think you're ready.
I need to be with Greg. And he needs me. It's been too long as it is.
I'm sure your husband would understand. You look better, you're sleeping better, but we still don't know what's caused it.
I have to go.
Well, your decision. But first sign of a relapse, I want you to take these, all right? And remember, don't do anything active afterwards. Might have a blackout.
I know, you've told me already.
But this could be anything, from late Pleistocene to pre-Columbian.
That's very early, I'm sure of it.
Well, I'm not saying it isn't, Greg, but you know as well as I do, without something you can put a carbon date on, it's worthless.
But we've got tools that we found up there. It's just a matter of time before we find the fire pit.
Greg, it's getting harder and harder for me to justify the grants with the rest of the department. You know I've been covering your tail.
Frank, it's just a little more time, that's all I'm asking.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Daddy.
You look beautiful.
Oh. I missed you so much.
I missed you too.
Something must have happened 4 months ago. Something quite traumatic. These kind of hallucinations don't just come out of nowhere.
And she still won't talk about it, huh?
Apart from saying that it started right after the funeral.
Well, that doesn't make sense. She was never close to Greg's mother.
I wish I had some answers for you.
So do I, because what you're saying is that in a week or a month, she could freeze up and begin staring at these walls again, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Look, Professor, mental disease is a bit like archaeology. You don't find answers just lying around on the surface. You have to keep digging.
I'm sorry, Doctor. She's my only child.
I know.
I want this to be a whole new start for us. I know that it was mostly my fault, but I feel so
much
better.
Don't blame yourself.
Well, if I do anything that bothers you, just tell me, okay?
Okay.
Don't hold it in.
I won't. I love you, Jan. I really missed you.
Jan, your father?
I'm gonna borrow my little girl for a minute. Come on, honey. Now, listen to me. Going straight from the hospital up to a dig in the mountains is crazy. Why don't you come home for a while and come up with me later in a couple of weeks?
Dad, Greg needs me. I can't be much of a wife if I'm 500 miles away.
What Greg needs is to get down to work. Okay. But I'm coming up to check on you in a couple of days.
Okay. Is this where you've been staying?
Yeah. I was really happy staying in the tent by the dig, but your father rented us this place.
Well, maybe we could get something a little cozier.
Oh, sure. Yeah, you want to be the one to tell your father you don't like it? Hmm. George forgot to turn on the electricity.
Who's George?
He's like the caretaker. I'm gonna call him. Hell, he's not there. What do you think?
There's something out there.
Really?
Greg.
Over here?
Hey.
Come out. Wherever you are,
come out.
Jen, there's nothing over here. You said right over there, right? Jesus, George, your dog just scared the hell out of me, man.
Mr. Sanderson, I'm sorry. Go on, get out of this. Get.
Wow.
I was in the stables. I didn't hear you pull up.
Well, I tried calling you. I can't get any lights.
Okay.
You fix that?
There you
go. Yeah. Oh, honey, this is George. That's my wife, Jen. I got to get some stuff out of the Jeep. Can you show her the house? Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Well, that's a big house. It's too much for one man to take care of. My boy Steven used to help out, but then he ran off to the big city. Now it's just me. Watch this board here. I gotta fix it.
So the owner doesn't use the house much?
Never. Don't mind these boxes. The last people who rented this place left in a right mess. Just took off. left all this stuff for me to clean up. Praise God, they also left the bar fully stocked. There's a nice view from up here. You'll like it. It catches the evening light just right. Just perfect.
So why did they leave?
On account of the stories.
What stories?
Ghost stories.
Are you serious?
About what?
You were talking about ghosts.
Oh, there ain't no ghosts. People just talk like that because of the murder, but that happened more than 20 years ago.
A murder? In this house?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, what happened?
You like ghost stories, don't you? The story goes that there was this hermit. People said he was kind of crazy. And he was squatting on the land out where the quarry is now. And nobody seemed to mind. I mean, it was just rough, wild land. It wasn't any good for anything. But then they figured out they could make a lot of money on that Santa Rita stone. So they come to him and they said, you know, gotta get out. But he refused. So they hired a bunch of quarry men. And they were gonna scare him, run him off. No. He took this off the quarry man. And he sneaked up to the landowner's house, got inside, and took after his daughter. Of course, she was scared. She ran. But swift, he cut off her foot. And swish, he cut off her leg. And swish, he cut off her head. Now remember, all this happened just before midnight.
Hello. Yeah. I didn't forget. Yeah, okay. Okay. I'll see you. Bye.
Who was that?
Miss Laura.
What did she want?
To, remind me that she's coming by for a couple of days.
Greg, I need to spend some time with you alone.
It's only for a couple of days.
That's what she said the last time.
I know. But she's moving to the East Coast, so this could be the last time I get to see my sister again for a long time.
When is she coming?
Tomorrow. I completely forgot. Jan. She's the only family I got left.
I don't know why you want to marry this woman. She's not your kind. Look at her hands. Those hands have never done a day's work in her whole life. Look at those hands. She knows nothing about the land. You're not going to live on this farm. She knows nothing about the land. Nothing.
Morning. It's only me. Brought you some flowers.
Oh, thank you. That's so sweet.
Is your husband around? Said something about a broken faucet.
Oh, he's over at the dig. Why don't you have some coffee with me?
Thanks. That one might be thirsty. But you know, my doctor said I shouldn't drink that. It's too stimulating.
Well, we have tea.
No, that's bare for the ticker, you know?
Well, the only other thing we have is in the bar.
That'll do in a pinch. You know, my doctor says it doesn't do any harm if you take it before 12 noon. My doctor's an alcoholic. I thought maybe you'd like to see this.
Who is this?
Steven. You know I told you.
He's very handsome.
Yeah, don't take after me much, does he? That's the trouble. City girls think he's handsome, too. I don't blame him much. Not much around here for young people to do.
What a great place. You must be George.
Yeah. Right. First time.
It's nice to meet you.
George is our resident storyteller. If you want to sleep at night, don't listen to anything he says.
But I love good stories.
I Hi, Laura. Jen, you look terrific. Are you feeling better?
Much better, thank you.
I'm sorry about barging in so soon, but I guess Greg explained.
Yeah, he tells me you're moving to the East Coast.
Mm-hmm. It's a big step, but I think it's good for my career.
Would you like some coffee? I just made some.
No, thanks.
Yeah.
There you go.
Thanks.
So how was your trip?
Fine.
Good, thanks.
Oh.
Is something wrong?
I guess it just perked a little too long.
Sorry.
I can make some for you.
I can just put some milk
in. No, I'll do it.
You know what? I gotta get to the dig anyhow. Would you ladies like to join me?
Yeah, yes. I have to change first.
I'll show you your room.
That's right, I'll do it, Jen. Follow me, Laura.
That's why I drink whiskey.
If I could just find a bone, a fragment, you know, a sliver of something to carbon date. I could prove this is the earliest Paleo-Indian culture in North America. It would make my career.
I can always tell when you've been working too hard.
How?
You forget to shave.
Right. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna go shave.
Well, would you like some wine and cheese?
That'd be nice. I'm gonna go freshen up. Mind if I take a shower?
I'm sorry, I'll come back a little later.
So he left the radio, and we pushed that thing all the way to the top of three trees.
Yes, but remember one thing.
But we were going to write it down.
There were not three trees in three
okay,
trees.
Okay,
there's
trees.
Two trees.
And then Michael.
Two trees and a bush.
Michael
was considered
took the bike
tree.
Down there. Thank you.
Hi, Jan. We wondered where you were. Why don't you come over and join us?
I'll be just a minute.
What is it? What is it?
Something wrong. I must have seen a shadow or something. I'm okay now. You surprised me. Sorry. I didn't know you were in here. Good morning. Have you had your breakfast yet?
I just had my vitamins. A, D, E, amino acids, liver tabs, iron.
Sweetheart, I'm surprised you don't rust. Come on, let me make you a nice barbaric breakfast of bacon and eggs.
I can't run on a full stomach.
Well, can't go anywhere without these.
Jan, give me my shoes. Give me my shoes. Come on, give me. Okay, forget about the shoes.
Morning, Laura.
Good morning. Would you like some coffee?
Yes, please.
Are you avoiding me?
I'm not avoiding you. Is it all right with you if I go for my run?
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. What happened to, you know, what's his name?
You know what happened? The same thing that always happens.
So as always, you come running to me.
And you know why? You know why? Look. Say the word and I'll go.
Greg? Is everything all right?
He forgot his glasses.
Yeah, I forgot my glasses. I'll be right back.
Hi.
Hi. It's pretty.
Thank you. Laura, I've had a lot of time to think these past 4 months. And I wanted to ask you about what happened last year.
What do you mean?
Everything was fine between Greg and me until your mother died. And he wouldn't say a word.
It takes time to sink in. You shouldn't think of it as a rejection. I'm sure he still loved you.
Really? Did he say so?
Well, no, but I'm sure he did.
I'm really hoping that this time...
You can't expect things to be exactly the same.
We love each other, Laura. Did you see the way he picked me up and he held me in his arms?
He did what?
He picked me up and he held me.
It must have been before I came down.
No, you were there. It was just a little while ago.
He did what exactly?
I took his running shoes and he chased me. And he picked me up. Don't you remember?
Maybe it was a dream.
No.
I wouldn't worry about it. It's understandable.
It happened. You're lying.
Well, what can I say? Okay, it happened. Doesn't matter to me. What exactly did he do? He did what?
He picked me up and held me.
Jack? I wanted to tell you that I'm sorry about our little misunderstanding. I shouldn't have doubted you.
You mean it did happen?
I guess I must have misinterpreted what I saw. Jen.
What
He forgot his glasses.
Awesome.
Jack. Come on. Wake up. Are you okay? Who is it? Who was it? Who was it? It was weird. Some guy was just breathing. I'm not imagining it. She's okay now. She'd been having some problems. Bad dreams, you know? Mm-hmm. So, what happened to you? You fell in a ditch? Okay. Okay. I'll go and get you. He's at George's place, but he can't find George, so I'm gonna go pick him up. Can I go with you? No. What exactly did he do? He did what?
He picked me up and held me.
What exactly did he do?
We love each other, Laura.
Maybe you dreamt it.
Hi, George.
Hey.
I brought you some coffee.
I don't know. You know me and coffee.
And a little whiskey, too.
Si, senorita. Mi habla whiskey. Yeah. Yeah. That's the best cup of coffee I have had in a long time. Oh, yeah.
Something wrong with the tractor?
It ought to be in a museum, that's all. I don't know. It's all I can do to keep it running. When Stephen was here, he could take this thing apart, put it back together again, in the same time it takes me to change the oil.
You must miss having him around. Stephen.
Yeah, I do. I don't know what he wants to live down in that city for. I mean, they got gangs and traffic and people killing each other. You know what I heard on the news the other night? There's a whole bunch of people who've been poisoned in Los Angeles.
Poisoned?
Yeah, you know those little pain capsules? Somebody's laced a whole bunch of them with arsenic. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Excuse me, George. Jan? She's out cold.
How many did she take?
Don't worry, it's almost full.
Are you feeling better now?
You like this, don't you?
Jesus Christ, Laura. Where's Jan?
I don't care.
Don't do this. Got a lot to do here, you know that. I'm trying to do something, okay?
Janice is really beautiful. Why don't you sit down with us? Cheers.
I just want some water.
What's going on?
Ah, she had a bad dream.
Did she take her pills?
No.
I'm sorry. Did I wake you up?
No, I just came down to water the plants.
Mad at me.
She's not mad at you. She's upset because she got woken up at 2 a.m.
Oh, I see. It's my fault because I woke her up. Well, if she wasn't here, I wouldn't be having these nightmares.
I don't want to fight with you.
Then get her out of here.
I can't just throw her out.
You know, ever since she arrived here, you've catered to her every need. I have played housemaid while you two carry on like... not like any brother or sister I know. Look, if you don't want me around, why don't you just divorce me and get it over with?
I can't believe you just said that. I love you. I want our marriage to work. I didn't plan on her being here.
I can't be here with her.
Can you be patient for a couple of days?
Either she leaves or I leave.
Oh, come on, Jan, don't do this.
Fine, I'm leaving.
Okay. I'll ask her to leave.
Ask.
I'll tell her to leave. Tomorrow, first thing.
Thank you.
I'm going to bed. Are you coming?
No, I think I'll stay up for a while.
Good night.
change a fuse.
He had a kind of axe, like the one that George showed me.
Oh, God, I wish he wouldn't have told you those stories. The front door?
Yes.
Jen, the door's bolted from the inside.
It must be in here somewhere.
Jan, there's nobody here.
I'm gonna call George. George, I'm sorry I woke you up. We had a prowler. Yes. Inside. Thanks, George.
Jan?
I know what I saw. And I am not having another breakdown.
Like a pajama party, don't it? It's probably some local kid. They like to scare city folk.
Would it frighten anyone if I lit a cigarette?
Jan, nobody is trying to hurt you.
See, this wouldn't have happened if you'd taken your pills.
Maybe she should take some now.
Yeah. I'll get them.
You know, it's usually in the soft dirt underneath your windows there that they find the footprints of a prowler. But there wasn't any this time. But I can't explain that.
How?
Under these windows, it's concrete.
George.
Why doesn't anyone believe me?
Whoa, now. Whoa, whoa. You don't want to let them get the best of you.
Here we go.
If he comes back, you pepper him with this. Give him a little country hospitality.
Thank you, George. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, George.
You know, I think we should all go to bed now.
I'm not tired.
Well, I certainly am. I'll see you all in the morning.
I'm just gonna stay here and watch the sun come up.
Huh?
I'll sleep during the day.
Suit yourself.
Jesus Christ, Jen!
You killed her.
Day.
Where am I?
What do you think?
Where's Laura?
She left.
She's not dead.
Dead? No, she's not dead. I didn't kill her, Jen. I just asked her to leave.
I shot her.
No. You're not a very good shot then, because she just walked out the door an hour ago.
So she's all right?
Well, she's upset because I asked her to leave early, but I stuck to my guns. And I know it's not your birthday, but today's as good a day as any. Look what I found.
Greg, what's going on?
Nothing's going on.
You're lying to me.
Lying? I got nothing to lie about.
It's Laura, isn't it? She's dead.
Dead? Jan, she left 2 days ago. She's not dead.
There's one way to find out.
I did it for us.
We had to call the police.
We can't.
Why?
It's too late. We're both accessories to murder.
But they'll know that she was missing.
Who will? I'm her only family.
Why are we doing this? It was an accident.
I know. I know, but they'll never believe you. You got a history of mental problems, babe.
I had a nervous breakdown and a few hallucinations.
That doesn't sound good. I'm telling you, they're gonna put you away. Laura didn't have a gun or a knife or anything.
I can't go along with this.
We don't have a choice. If we call the police, do you think they're gonna believe that you thought you saw a ghost? We can't change what happened. Last Laura forever. But what's done is done. I love you, Jim.
I'm so scared.
Me too.
Jan, what are you doing?
I was just checking.
George sees you checking at night. In the garden, what's he gonna think? What's the matter with you?
I'm sorry. I kept getting the feeling that she wasn't properly covered.
What?
I have this terrible urge to see her.
Jan, come on.
I can't go on like this. There was a dead body up there.
You gotta keep it together.
Please, Greg, please, let's leave this place.
We can't. We gotta get George out of here for a couple of days, and then we can move Laura. Gotta keep it together, Jan. Listen to me. Listen. We could lose everything. Do you understand? They'll put you away. Do you understand? You gotta keep it together.
All right.
Okay. It's better. Feel better? Okay. We gotta work through this. I gotta go up to the dig. I left all my stuff up there.
Don't leave me.
I'll be right back. I can't do anything without it. I'll be right back. Okay? Thank you.
Charcoal. Charcoal, get away from there. Charcoal, come here. Come on.
Charcoal, come here.
Charcoal, come on.
Come on. Hurry, Nava. What's the matter with you? I've never known him to mess with flowers like that. What are you after? What are you looking for?
Would you like to go inside and have a drink, George?
Huh?
I've got a bottle of single malt scotch.
That's whiskey, right?
Yes.
That's an interesting garden you got out there.
How do you mean?
Well, just grows so fast. Beats the daylights out of mine. What do you use for fertilizer?
Nothing special.
Well, you got a green thumb, I'll say that. I'm sorry about the dog. They just like to dig. Boy, it's a shame that sister of yours had to leave so soon. That's why I came by. To tell you that I'm gonna be gone for a couple of days. I got a brother down in Millville who's sick. Thought I'd just go over there and see if I could help him out.
That's nice of you. You never seem to stop working.
Yeah, I like to keep busy. You know, we were there. You're alone, it kind of keeps your mind off things. Been a long time since my dear wife departed.
I had no idea that she had died.
No? No, she ain't dead. Just departed. Yeah. She's a wonderful wife, the old bitch.
Why'd she leave?
Oh, she didn't like country life. Not enough excitement. You know, same old story.
Well, it's hard living in the country if your heart's not in it.
Her sure wasn't. I never could understand it. I used to tell her I thought she fit in perfect. You could put her in a pasture of cows, and it'll take you 10 minutes to figure out which one she was. Wait a minute. What's this? What's this here?
What?
Embedded in the arm of this chair. Shotgun pellets. They look new. Got any idea how these got here?
No. Not at all.
Remember, don't point this at anything you don't want to shoot. I'll be back in a couple of days.
Yeah. I think somebody slugged me from behind. I don't know. What are you doing here?
Laura's disappeared.
What?
I saw her in the bell tower and now she's gone.
God, you know George must be behind all of this. Jesus Christ.
Stephen.
Who's Stephen?
It's George's son. I saw a picture of him wearing it.
Go on.
She could get away. And that bastard, Stephen.
George.
What are you doing with that gun? Jan. It's me. It's George. You know me, don't you?
Stand back.
What's the matter with you? Are you making things up in your mind again? What's the matter with you? It's George. I think you better give me the gun.
I said stand back.
Just give me the gun. I'm your friend. This is just a big mistake.
Oh, shoot!
Don't. Listen, it's a dream. It's a dream. I'm your friend. I know you're not gonna shoot George. Give me the gun. Give me the gun.
Jen!
We have to call the police.
What about Laura?
It was George who set it up. They'll know when they see the mask.
Okay.
Looks like the country boy is out you again. This time, I mean, damn sure there were blanks in that gun.
Get out of here. Tell me this is just a nightmare.
It is.
Al! What are you doing?
You okay?
Okay! You nearly killed me, you son of a...
Well, I had to make it look real. Let's have a drink.
Yeah.
I guess we gotta talk about business, huh?
We got to change our terms. I didn't know anybody was gonna get killed.
She would still be alive if you'd have taken the shot out of the gun!
I checked that shotgun, you saw me do it! Now, I know there's something going on between you and that sister of yours. I know that,
don't
I know.
Don't give me the self-righteous shit, man! Any man that kills his own son is no saint, pal.
When Stephen died, that just happened.
You know, that was a really useful fossil. That's the best one I ever found.
I was crazy. I didn't know what I was doing. You planned this, didn't you? See, I know you did. But I won't tell. Not a soul. No, sir. All you gotta do is to pay me double.
That'd do it, huh? I'll tell you what. I had to pee exactly nothing. You can take the rap for the whole fucking deal. Great stuff, isn't it? Antimony, George. It simulates a heart attack. And doesn't leave a trace. Yeah. You know, I like you a lot better this way.
You know, I think I like you better this way.
Thank you.